This next vehicle may seem like the odd man out on our list, but it had a key role in the Allied victory of World War II.
The LVT-4 Alligator. Manufacturer, Food Machinery Corporation. Power plant, one Continental 250 horsepower radial gasoline engine. Maximum speed, 25 miles per hour on land, 7 miles per hour on water. Carrying capacity, 6 crew and 30 troops. Armor, 0.5 inches. Armament, 2.50 caliber and 2.30 caliber machine guns. Range, 300 miles on road, 75 miles on water.
Known as amphibious tractors, or Amtraks for short, LVTs were the backbone for the US Marine landings during the long and bloody campaigns of the Pacific War. But the original idea of an amphibious landing craft came not from America, but from Japan.
The only people at the beginning of the Second World War who had purpose-built amphibious assault equipment were the Japanese. As an island nation, the Japanese understood that they would have to, in a modern war, conduct amphibious operations. And it is, in fact, the Japanese who invent modern amphibious landing equipment.
By mid-1943, Allied forces were trying to win back the Japanese-held islands of the Pacific. American commanders knew that to get their troops safely onto the beaches, they would need an effective armored transport vehicle. They already had the Higgins boat, but they needed more than a mere landing craft.
To any American planner who has got to look at the idea of getting across the vast blue Pacific Ocean, to get anywhere near the Japanese home islands, you want to be able to take a tracked tin can full of Marines and put it on shore and allow them to operate without depending on yet another piece of equipment.
The answer was the LVT Mark IV. Introduced in 1944, this innovative vehicle had a rear door from which either a jeep or gun could be unloaded. But more importantly, it could carry its crew safely beyond the shoreline.
Having a vehicle that wouldn't simply land on the beach, drop the bow, and have everybody run out into harm's way, but actually go onto the beach, transition onto land, provide a platform from which you could actually fight, as well as protection for the squad on board, was a real revolutionary change in amphibious warfare.
And with a range of onboard armaments, anything from 50 caliber machine guns to 75 millimeter howitzers, the LVT had plenty of firepower to protect its 30 disembarking troops.
The LVTs worked in teams where they were almost miniature armies, if you will, where they put artillery in and then softened up the target, followed by infantrymen. And they even had repair LVTs, which were outfitted with winches and could conduct major repairs on the beach. And they would simply go from island to island to island, clearing out the Japanese.
For innovation, this amphibious original earns top marks. And with over 1,900 LVT-4s built, its production score is strong, as is its carrying capability. But marks for service length and mobility are down. So the LVT-4 comes in at ninth place on our